Merde, Yosef. Merde. Shut up. Shut up and listen. Shut up and listen to the eloquence of silence. From my tongue to your ears, dialect. It's simple dialect, complex in a sense, but it still makes sense. You see, they call us the leaders of tomorrow. Cliche, huh? But you see, we're just the writers of sorrow, including him and her. You see, we need to raise the bar, walk us far, take a stand and make it grand. Create a brand with strands that transcend through the essence of sense. The presence of sense should be our core job. But you see, they're like weevils. Evil people who forget their roots and ditch their people. So they bore holes in society and blind us by digging bore holes in calamity. They don't prevent the tragedy. They only rush after the reality. So the reality is the tragedy graduating into calamity, some famine, some drugs, some poverty. Empty plate, empty cup, empty pockets. And so we mutate into pick pockets, who pick from empty pockets as they pick from every docket and open every locket. And I don't even own a jacket, let alone a closet. This stinks. This stinks. That's why we must think before we dip that thumb in ink again. Because if not, the stinking won't stop, but the shilling will drop. Drop in value, drop in life, drop from value down to strife. You see, it's funny how they promise us good roads, good health, and good education, whereas the only implication is setting up commissions after being hit with sheer allegations and some very queer instigations. Yes, that's the situation. The same promises they made during the previous generations are the same promises they make in this one. This blunder is a big one, and that's why we need a strategy to stop this travesty and animosity. And by animosity, I'm talking Wajiru, Wagala, and Tana. I think we need a page turner. Cut the blunder, avoid the blunder. It's about time to draw a line between retrogressive and progressive. Active and proactive, customary and visionary. So think. Think before you dip your thumb in ink.
Again.
ASAP.